I like to make things in Softr, and I like to make integrations in Softr. That's right, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to use Softr's make.com integration to make things that much simpler when it comes to automation and workflows inside of Softr. Let's get started. First of all, for those of you that haven't heard of make.com before, it is a no-code automation platform that allows you to connect various applications through their custom API connections to perform specific tasks. To get things started, when you are going to look for the integration, I would go to make.com/integration/Softr, and you can see the different modules that is integrated into Make system. First and foremost, I would sign up to make.com, and then once you are in the platform, you can go ahead and make your first scenario. So go to scenarios here and press create a new scenario. Now you can not only just utilize Make through this experience, but you can also utilize forms within Softr, which we'll get into later, that allow you to submit data through Softr into Make for a fun automation step-by-step workflow. So first of all, just as an example, if I were to type Softr here and then click on it, say we were to create a user within Softr. What we want to do first is press add in order to add a Softr connection. So what you first need to do actually in order to connect to make.com is go to your My Account settings in your Softr account and go to API. And then you're going to copy this API key, go into your Softr integration on make.com. And then you're going to paste this within here. And then you're going to pick whatever the Softr domain is for your application. So say we were to pick a specific app. For example, let's go to this applicant tracking one here. You can see that there's this domain. Once it's published, we can copy this application link and then paste it within here. And then we would remove this and just leave this right here. So now that we've connected this, we can actually just make another instance of this. And by doing add a module, then create user, then for example, connect to an account like MailChimp and then watch subscribers. So let's say when a new subscriber were to join a list after I connect my account in a similar manner by pressing add and then logging into my MailChimp account, I can then pick a list ID. And when the status is subscribed, I can then create a new user based off of the email address within here. Then you can put the name of the person sign up in MailChimp, and then you can put in the password as well. So once those fields are mapped, we can turn this on to run however often we want. So this varies based on your plan, but you could set it up to regular intervals, once a day, once, days of the week, days of the month, or any specific dates. So if we set this to every day, we can set off the specific time. Then after saving it, we can turn it on. And at any time we would get a subscriber in MailChimp, it would create a user in our Softr connection that is connected to this applicant tracking system. Now, that's one direction, not like the band. And then another really cool use case is for something like digital asset management. If we were to go into this, adding an asset or even requesting an asset uses a form. So in customizable forms, pressing plus, you can go to customizable form and add it. We scroll down here, you can see that there is this destination slot right here, right? So for example, we can send this to data source, add to MailChimp, add to MailerLite, Zapier, or Make, as well as forward to your email. So if we send it to Make, what we then could do is, for example, in a use case like this, set it up so that the destination, rather than sending to the data source, could actually send to Make. And then if we made an automation within make.com that sent this to a project management system, if we were using something that wasn't Airtable, or if we just needed to send it to Make so that it could like send out an email chain or send it through Slack as a notification, we can make that happen. So by scrolling down here, you'll see that the submit button then is like this webhook. So it has the step-by-step outline here. So say for example, you can go into Make and press create scenario. Then following the directions, select webhooks. Then we do custom webhook, create a webhook. Then we would copy this right here, throw it down into this. We can click here to send test data. And you can see that it says successfully determined, which means boom, it's connected inside of make.com. So then from there, say like, for example, we wanted to go to Slack. And when somebody were to submit a request, I could say, okay, let's create a message inside of my Slack. I have a Slack bot. Once you allow the workspace through adding a connection to make.com, we could either pick a channel ID or name. I personally like selecting from a list, just a little bit easier to work with. And rather than having it go to a public channel, let's do a IM, so like an instant message channel. Then have the user be Slackbot and have the text say, have a new digital asset request in your Softr app. And press OK. So for example, when something would be submitted after turning this on, then we could, for example, test this guy out. So if we were to request an asset using Demetri at softr.io, and then the request name would be the best video of all time. Press submit. It says, thank you, your request has been submitted. You can see right here, the activity actually ran. It took the best video of all time and sent a message, you have a new digital asset. So if you wanted to make that a little bit more specific, what you can do is utilize the name. So go here. So you have a new digital asset, put name right here in your Softr app, and then press save. Once again, you can also select between different private channels or public channels. It's whatever you're most comfortable with and whatever is needed for your team. Now, in order to make sure that it's an IM channel, you're gonna wanna make sure that you add a connection to the user connection option. So for example, I'm gonna pick Demetri and then do this test again. So Demetri at softr.io. The request name would be a really, really cool thumbnail. Press submit. Since this is set to immediately, it should run as soon as the information gets there, and then send me a DM on Slack. As you can see, this time it was sent them with the message, you have a new digital asset request, and then the name, a really, really cool thumbnail in your Softr app. The make.com integration is awesome inside of Softr. We have other integrations as well, and we have other tips and tricks on how to use our awesome app. So make sure to check them out by clicking on this video on how to improve your Softr skills even more.